Hello, guys. Today we're going to learn about the five-finger exercise number one. This is a preparatory exercise for building and developing proper hand technique on the piano. So let's begin by learning about the four steps. First, step A. Okay, so step A requires placing the left hand and the right hand in C position. Work one hand at a time, obviously. So we have here our left hand in C position. Let's play all the keys harmonically. It is important to maintain our fingers in a curved shape at all times, not letting the fingers sink in like this. We don't want that to happen. We always want the knuckles of the fingers to be outward, not inward, but outward, okay? Let's place our fingers curved with the arm, the wrist, and the hand perfectly straight. See how straight that is? And our fingers are also curved. Let's play these again harmonically. So step A is taking the wrist with the other hand and lifting it up like this and bringing it down into C position. Lifting the wrist, hand, and then fingers follow, and then they come back down into C position. Do that a few times. Also, do it with the right hand, lifting the hand, fingers, and then falling back into C position, just like that. A few times with me. Very good. Next, we try step B, which is lifting the wrist, the hand, and the fingers without the aid of our other hand. So lift wrist, hand, and fingers up like this, bring it down, back into C position. So one part at a time, and then bring it back down, okay? Remember, pretend like your hand is lifeless, and it's simply being raised up and brought back down into C position. Okay, now for step C. Step C requires us to lift very small distance up, and we stroke the keys like this. Okay, really small lifts, stroking the keys, maintaining the curve shape in our hands, and stroking. Let's now try with the right hand. Small lifts, stroking the keys. Remember, don't bring the fingers too far in to the black keys. Bring them mostly behind or in front of the black keys. Lift and stroke, very small lifts. Very good. Let's now try step D. Step D is everything put together, but we are playing five finger exercise number one. So as we lift, come down on C, lift, come down on D, lift on E, lift F, lift G. Hold for four beats because it's a whole note. 2, 3, 4, back down. Excellent. Let's now try with the right hand. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, and release. Good job. When you are ready and have practiced each hand individually and have mastered each exercise, try them together, with both hands being lifted up, stroking the keys, and coming down. Five finger exercise number one, playing them melodically, okay? Maintain the curvature in the fingers. Straight arm, straight wrist, straight hand. Let's try this together. One, two, three, four. 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 Release. Looks like I added a whole note at the end of that. You can do that too if you'd like. Please practice this exercise every day. A few times a day. Remember to practice finger exercise number one before you go on to finger exercise number two. So just as a supplement at the end, after you've mastered exercise number one, it should be easier to play number two. Lift the hand. Etc. Now remember, when we play number two, all fingers must remain down except for the one being repeated four times. And keep in mind, the knuckles have to be outward and not inward. Outward, please. All the time, curvature in the fingers. Practice this every day. Good luck!